Hello everyone, my name is Divya Pelnekar and today I am here with Rujita Dahiya. We are here to discuss on the topic called Software Architecture 2. Before talking about software architecture tool, let's discuss about what is software architecture. The architecture of a system describes major component and the structure. We can say that architecture is a blueprint of a system. What are the goals of software architecture? The main goal of software architecture is to understand the structure of a system and hides the implementation. It also realized all the use case scenario. It handles the functional and quality requirements.
From till now, you learn what is software architecture and which different goals are used in software architecture. Now we learn here the different types of software architecture. There are so many types of software architectures. For example, three trial, model view controller, multi-layered architecture, a blackboard pattern, microkernel, presentation abstraction controller, etc. Now we learn the tools are used for software architecturing for different modules. For example, Lucy charts are mainly used for flow diagram, chart diagrams. As same as we can say, Microsoft Visio are also help for architecturing. Google Slider are there. Creately software are also there. Edro, Pidoco, OmniGraffles. These are software are used for architecturing for a different types of modules. Okay, now we learn what are the benefits of software architecture tool. Firstly, it's create a solid platform for the project. It's also make platform scalable. It's also help to increase our quality and performance of the platform. It manage a complexity. It helps to reduce cost and avoid code duplicity. It's make a platform faster. It's also help to risk management. It helps to reduce risk and chance to failure. It reduce to time to market. Reduce a development time. Okay, now we learn what are the limitations of software architecture. There are some lack of tools and there are no such way of standardized to represent architecture. There are also lack of analytic method to predict whether architecture will result in an implementation that meets a requirement. There are also lack of awareness of the importance of architectural design to software development. There are also lack of understanding of the designing process, designing expressions, and evaluate the design. There are also lack of understanding the role of software architecture and poor communication among the stakeholder. I hope you understand the concepts of software architecture. What is software architecture? What are the goals of software architecture? Which types of software architectures are there? What are the benefits? What are the limitations? And which types of tools for software architecture? Thank you for listening our session.